Is your Mac running low on disk space? You are not alone. In today's video, you will learn how to easily increase your Mac's disk space by removing Sequoia's aerial wallpapers and screensavers. This will help you store more valuable data and enhance your Mac's system performance. In this tutorial, I will demonstrate two methods for deleting aerial wallpapers and screensavers on either macOS Sequoia or Sonoma. Before we begin to delete the aerial wallpapers, open System Settings by clicking its icon in the dock. Then select Wallpaper from the left sidebar. Next, browse through the available wallpapers to select the static wallpaper from the Pictures section. Then click Show All to view all the static wallpapers on your Mac. Choose one, or you can choose one of your own images, such as a family photo or a picture of your pet. This ensures your desktop has a background image after you remove the live aerial wallpapers. To find the location of downloaded wallpapers, click on your desktop to ensure the Finder is active. Then click the Go menu and select Go to Folder. Copy and paste this folder location into the text box. Then press Enter on your Mac keyboard. You can find the folder destination in the description box below this video. You can now see the downloaded live aerial wallpapers and screensavers in this folder. To find out how much space these high-definition video clips occupy on your Mac SSD or hard disk drive, right-click or control-click inside the folder and select Get Info. This folder occupies around 2 GB on my MacBook Pro SSD, which is quite big. To find out how much space each individual wallpaper occupies, control-click or right-click on one, select Get Info. As you can see, this one takes over 400 megabytes. You can now check this folder on your Mac and determine which movie files to delete and which to keep to optimize disk space and speed up your Mac performance. To remove them, press Command plus A to select all the files, then drag them to the trash, or right-click and choose Move to Trash. Enter your user account password and click OK. The second method is to double-click your hard disk and open the library folder, application support, idle assets D, and customer folder. Finally, you can find your aerial wallpapers and screensavers in this folder.
If you like this video, make sure to subscribe and ring the bell for more. Thank you.
As you may already know, before downloading an aerial wallpaper or a screensaver, you will see a download arrow below each thumbnail. Once the download is completed, the arrow will disappear, indicating that the item has been downloaded. To ensure that the arrow reappears below the thumbnail after you delete a wallpaper, close the System Settings window and reopen it to see the change reflected. You may have to do this a couple of times. If you still can't see the arrows, close the system settings window and restart your computer. As you can see, the download arrows appear after restarting my Mac, indicating that the aerial wallpapers can be redownloaded. By the way, if you want to delete the dynamic wallpapers, please watch this video. The tutorial link is in the description box. If you are looking for free applications to fix your Mac's issues and enhance performance, click more below this video to find the link to the tutorials in the description box. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, please consider subscribing by clicking on my profile picture and sharing the video links with your friends. Your support will inspire me to create more videos for you. Thank you for watching.